Okay, now, Munif, first of all, congratulations. You did it. So, how are you feeling,
Thank you,
first of all?
sir.
So,
I'm
it
so
is a
much
day.
relieved now. I am so much relieved now, and finally the hard working I have reached to the success. That was actually the hard working and your dedication.
Okay, thank you. So
Yes.
tell everyone how many above target you got? How many about target?
These are five above targets,
Five
sir.
above target. Ladies and gentlemen, second student in 3 days, five above target. So,
Okay.
five above target. Can you show us for just the audience so that they can believe it? Can you show five above target, please?
Oh, actually, I have a printed paper.
Yeah,
So let me see if
since you give the exam
you can
in,
see if it
yeah, we
is
can.
clear to you.
Above target, above target, above target, above target. And you also send me. So for the audience, I can also show them or WhatsApp image. You can put it down now. This
Sure.
is the five above target document. Okay. So coming back to the point, Munib, how you did it?
Oh, sir, actually, I think that it was all your effort, not mine, because you were pushing me so hard, and my family said one time that you didn't read the books even in the FSC like that.
Okay.
Like even you are reading nowadays. So you pushed me hard, and it was all the effort for the previous 2 weeks. For the previous 2 weeks, you pushed me hard to read the PIM book, read your notes. Actually, your notes helped me a lot. Your notes, all the things are available in your notes.
Okay.
And from those notes, if you want to read the PIM book, that is okay. But if someone has studied your notes, then he has great chances of successfully doing the PMP.
Okay.
So after that, you pushing me hard to do the mocks, and I think I have done three mocks in a day as well.
Okay. Yeah. So
It's
it all comes
really
down
hard.
to it is it all comes down to hard work, how much effort you put, how much dedication to put. And it is basically for every student that
Yes, exactly.
you have to work hard. So just tell us about exam. We are hearing the feedback that we are getting 60 to 80 questions about change request. So what was it?
Exactly.
So you get 60.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. 60 to 80 question from change request. Actually, change request covers all the area, even in the planning, monitoring and controlling, execution and closing.
Okay.
Anytime you can get a change request. Scenarios are different,
Okay.
but ultimately you have to follow or refer the change management plan.
Okay.
So you have to understand the lines of the question,
Okay.
and then you have to follow the change management plan.
Agreed.
So I think that the change request cycle that you have given us, and I think there are videos of you as well
Sure,
on the
sure.
YouTube,
I will
they
put
can
it.
help a lot.
I'll put it the link of change request video in here. Okay. So
Yes.
that covers a lot of. Then my favorite thing, flow of process. How does it help?
It helped me a lot. Actually, I recommend every person to watch that video of you, which describes 49 processes flow.
Okay.
And when you learned that video and you make a story of your own about that 49 processes, then you are very easy and relaxed to attempt the exam.
Okay.
Because when you see the statement of the question, then then your mind iterates that which process in which process you are.
Okay.
And then according to that process, you apply tools and techniques, you have learned the outputs. So major outputs plus 49 processes story, that
Okay.
is very critical to pass the exam.
Like basically, what was my all daily focus to you? Watch daily change request video,
Yes,
watch
yes,
and read.
yes.
Basically, make the 49 processes and follow
Exactly,
the processes
exactly.
and see how basically moves. So, how many questions
Exactly.
basically were about ITTOs? People are so much worried about ITTOs. Direct questions about the ITTO. How many questions were there?
Not so much, not so much. Directly, ITTO questions were around about 20 to 30. Most of
Okay.
the questions were actually scenario based.
Okay.
Most of the questions were scenario based. direct ITTOs, and I think if you have got the direct ITTOs question, then that one are the free marks for you.
Okay.
Because after learning those processes and learning the major outputs and major tool and techniques, you come to know that exactly related to ITTOs, those questions are actually free marks for you.
Those questions are actually...
They are very simple questions.
Okay. Being said that, how many questions from communication and stakeholder? That was my second topic. The specific chapter I asked you to read, at least I think two times, read communication and stakeholder. So how many questions from there?
I can't exactly recall, but there were a lot of questions. I think they lie in between 40 to 50 questions. Hmm.
Good question.
Which were relating to communication and stakeholders. After every three, four question, I see that I have got the question of stakeholder, either stakeholder or the communication. And were information sharing, report sharing, stakeholder engagement. So these were the things, I think 40 to 50 questions were there in the PMP exam from these areas.
Okay. What about risk?
Risk. Actually, risk techniques are much important. How to avoid risk, exploit, when to exploit, when to avoid. So basically, you have to go through those techniques.
Okay.
Because I think 7 to 8 questions were from there that they have given a scenario and they say that the manager would avoid it, accept it, or mitigate it, or exploit it. So I think there were 7 to 8 questions from these areas.
Okay. Good.
Also, there were 3-4 questions about the identify risk as well, and 4 to 5 questions regarding the issue log as well. So I think whenever you are studying the risk, there were 2 to 3 questions, I think qualitative and quantitative analysis.
Okay.
Now I recall there were 2 to 3 questions. So if you go through the whole chapter of risk, I think there were 12 to 15 questions from the risk.
12 to 15 questions. And the risk is a very important topic. We understand.
Yes.
Okay. Any question regarding contract type, fixed price, things like that?
Yes. I think 4 to 5 questions were there. Fixed price, economic price adjustment, and time and material, cost plus.
I would say they are free numbers. If you understand.
Yes, exactly. Exactly.
Contract one time, they are the like fixed.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Now tell us about basically which is the most important topic if you are preparing apart from stakeholder change request. Communication, we discussed stakeholder. Integration, how we go to integration. What were the questions from scope? Then I received a question to ask you, what were the questions from earned value and critical path method?
From the critical path method, there were actually 2 questions.
Okay.
Only 2 questions, and they were so simple that the activity actually it was on the critical path, and its answer was 0. So I can say you that regarding the formula question first, there were 4 to 5 questions,
okay.
And I didn't even open the calculator for that. They were so much easy questions. You can calculate on your fingertips as well.
So
that were very much easy question, and same as the ITTOs, they are also the free marks question.
Okay.
So most of the people bother regarding those formula question. So I think don't bother them. Actually, they have to bother is actually the stakeholder communication change request. That is much more important than that.
Okay.
So, and coming to the scope, there were a lot of questions regarding the collect requirements.
Okay.
Requirement documentation, requirement traceability metrics. These are much more important topics and also interrelated to each other. Sometimes you got confused that whether it is a requirement documentation or requirement traceability metrics. Because you see that there is a very thin line between these two topics.
So how do you differentiate? Can you put a light here so that it gets clear once for all? What was the difference between requirement documentation and
testing? Actually, requirement documentation is that documentation in which you collect all the requirements out there. Okay. And requirement traceability matrix, it actually relates the requirement towards that of the deliverable that is you are going to prepare at the end of the phase or project.
That's why you got 5 above target. Exactly the great difference. Let me just reiterate in my words. Requirement documentation is basically business requirement, solution requirement, functional requirement, non-functional requirement. Exactly. All the requirements that you need and their types. Requirement traceability documentation, RTM, is the alive document in which you get all the requirement from the start till the end.
Yes.
Even those requirements don't go to define scope, but still the status of the requirement will be there. So that is a very important thing. Okay, coming to the next topic, any other important area? You were saying something about resource?
Yes, yes. I think there were 20 to 30 questions regarding the resources. If some resource leave your project, if some resource... you also know that this kind of thing relate to change management as well. Mm-hmm. But there were a lot of questions from the resource, how you will handle the resources, now the situation is that, and how you will lead the team. So these were the how you will assess the team. So resource is very important topic as well. Apart from the risk, if you give the priority, then you are coming to a stakeholder and communication at the top, because those topics are, I think for me, those topics were very much confusing before these 2 weeks.
Okay.
After that, risk is much important. Then you come to resource. That is also a topic that sometimes confuses you. Sometimes. But okay. I think you must prepare it very well.
Okay, now like the video we have made about resource theories, all basically covered resource.
Yes, yes,
so we
yes,
can,
yes.
You, for everyone who is watching here, we have a video on resource. You can watch that. I'll also ping it there. We have a change request video. You can watch that. Then we have some coaching call. You can watch along that way. Okay, any other topic? And I'm coming to some big questions here.
Actually, I have... we have covered all the topics. I think good. Schedule, there were 5 to 10 questions from the schedule as well.
So you did
quality, 5 to 10 questions from the quality as well, different area, manage quality and control quality, and 1 to 2 questions from quality management plan as well.
Okay. So you did basically prepcast, of course. You did Udemy, the one which I gave you. Then you did other mocks, a lot of mocks you did in the last 2 weeks. And then... All these mocks, we understand the prepcast is important. We have gotten the feedback of a lot of students that prepcast is very good, and I highly recommend that. Regarding about Udemy course, how was it? Was it effective?
Udemy course is very much effective. Very much effective.
Very much.
Actually, the critical point is that when I got from you, make me understand that whenever you do a question wrong, please understand why you did it wrong. Frankly speaking, when you are in the exam, you again see that you are... I had given this exam 1 week ago, and those were the questions came like this kind of exam. So actually, what is very important, you must understand the analogy of the question.
Good.
What is he saying?
What
read the question. One more thing from my lesson learned is that I had a lot of problem in the time management. I already had done so much mocks. You know, I think I have given 14 to 15 mocks to you.
Okay.
I think.
Okay. Okay.
But this time again, I had very much time management problem. And for the first 89 questions, the question were lengthy as well.
Okay.
First 89 questions were a little bit lengthy. There were 3 to 4 liner question as well. Almost 30% question I have attempted today, they were 3 to 4 liners, 30% of the question.
Okay.
All other 50% question were 2 to 2.5 liner.
Okay.
And 20% question were one liner. Okay.
Okay.
So you must have to understand what he, and then you pick.
Okay. Okay. Sorry, the internet got interrupted. So questions were 3-4 line. You have to use analogy. You have to understand it.
Take a second. Okay.
So we had some internet issue. Okay. Yes. As you were saying, that questions were 2-3 lines, and then all the analogy that has helped you along the way. So basically, what is the strategy you used for solving the question? Like the strategy I was saying a few days back, read the option first and read the last line. You use that, or you use a normal strategy of reading the question and then the option. So what was the strategy?
Actually, you stopped me from that strategy.
Yeah. Okay,
first read those options.
Okay.
So I just went with my own strategy that just read the question. I think I studied the question at least 2 times.
Okay.
To find what is the analogy in which process the question is, and then I go towards the answers. Okay. And then after that, actually it was pick the odd one out. Basically, you filter out the exact answer, and at the end you have two answers that are confusing you, and after that you find the analogy in which process you are, and then you apply the tools and techniques for that answer.
Okay.
So basically all this strategy was from your side, whatever you have given the knowledge to me, I applied.
Okay. So very important thing, when you are preparing your exam, when you are going in your exam, you did in the center, so that test all those issues got removed along the way. You understand the flow. You made stories. You did the mock. You did all the thing right. You did the change request. Now, for all the students who are watching it, if they come in my 7 days program, and I will, as we do 49 processes, flow of the processes, flow of change request, understanding three baseline, which I'm always saying, scope, cost, schedule, and what can damage, risk, including the risk response, importance of communication, importance of stakeholder, when to use communication plan, when to use stakeholder plan, journey of stakeholder, journey of deliverable, journey of change request, a journey of work performance data, how data move from information to report to, it goes to all those things. Then understanding all the output, the reason of the processes, as I said, if someone understand all these things, which I just said, and do like 4 to 5 good mocks, which you have already recommended, can they clear the exam?
Sir, actually, if they have understood what you have given them the knowledge, they can clear the exam in 1 week as well. Because what you have taught me, all is about that. All the PMP is about that. About 49 processes, change request, deliverable journey, 3 baselines. All is that what is PMP. And if you have a dedicated work for 1 week, you can clear the exam very easily.
Okay. So, like, you have to put dedication. That is for sure.
Yes.
7 days.
Dedication and hard working is very much recommended.
7 days. With dedication, understanding the flow, understanding what Muneeb is saying, what I am saying, you can clear PMP exam. So thank you, Muneeb, and enjoy the post-PMP journey, and have fun, enjoy your life, and best of luck for future endeavors.
Thank you.